ahead on NCBA's Cattlemen to Cattlemen.
On this week's special edition of NCBA's Cattlemen to Cattlemen, we sit down with a team of industry experts to learn more about genetic evaluation, DNA testing, and how it can mean more money for your operation.
And now, a special edition of NCBA's Cattlemen to Cattlemen with host Kevin Ochsner.
Hello and welcome to this week's edition of NCBA's Cattlemen to Cattlemen. I'm Kevin Ochsner. Thanks for joining us. This week, we're sitting down with the experts to talk about DNA testing and what it can mean for your operation. And joining me in the studio, Dr. Kent Andersen, the Associate Director of Technical Services for Pfizer Animal Genetics, Dr. Tom Field, Executive Director of Producer Education for the National Cattlemen's Beef Association, and Jarold Callahan, President of Express Ranches, and also Vice President of the American Angus Association Board of Directors. Gentlemen, thanks for coming to the show.
Thank you.
You know, we want to start by talking a little bit about genetic evaluation in general. And Kent, I guess I'd pose the first question to you. Of all the things we manage in beef cattle production, what's the importance of genetic evaluation?
Well, Kevin, genetics really sets the stage for the rest of the production chain. Most of our traits are 0.2 to 0.4 heritable or higher. And so we can set that stage for production right up front. For example, if you're interested in calving these bulls and you want to make sure you have a good calving experience, genetics can set that stage right up front. Or for another example, if you're interested in feedlot growth and efficiency, by virtue of capitalizing upon our genetic information, you can help to roll back those costs of gains and increase your productivity and profitability.
And Tom, what would you tell us based on your perspective of the role of genetic evaluation in modern beef production?
Well, think about our industry today. We have opportunities to pursue unique market niches with very unique standards on carcass and potentially feed yard performance. Meanwhile, back at home at a cow-calf operation, it's the age-old question, how do I get the environment and the genetics I've got to work together to produce a productive herd? And if I'm going to do that without genetic evaluation, it's like trying to literally land a plane on an aircraft carrier with no navigation system at night. You're going to be lucky if you ever hit the target, and if you happen to land, that'd be amazing. Mm-hmm. So what genetic evaluation gives us is a really much more assurance that the choices we're making are actually going to move our population in the direction we want, and it also provides us a way to stay out of the bar ditches, so I don't go too far left with the trait, say too little birth weight, or I don't go too far to the right with too much birth weight. Same thing on all the other traits really that we work with.
Jarold, there's been a lot of changes in genetic evaluation even in the last 30 or 40 years. I'd be interested in your perspective relative to the evolution of genetic evaluation, and then more importantly, what does it mean to breeders like yourselves and commercial cattlemen and frankly the beef industry in general?
Yeah, it really has been quite an evolution. We've been trying to measure performance for many, many years, and we did it oftentimes in the early days with gain tests like at bull test stations. And then along in the 80s, we started with breeding values, and they worked very well, and they were the first step in the process that formed expected progeny differences, or EPDs, which most commercial cattlemen and purebred breeders work with on a daily basis. Now we have the added piece of the genomically enhanced EPDs. And I think what it does, not only for our operation, it allows us to have a greater confidence in the data that we utilize. At the Angus Association, we really have the largest database of any purebred association in history. And with that realm of data, it gives us the confidence that, as Tom, like Tom said, when we're selecting for a low birth weight bull, that the database is there on the sire and the dam and his individual performance, and so consequently not only us but our end user, the commercial man, can make an informed, intelligent decision and hopefully, as was stated earlier, have a good calving experience.
Dr. Andersen, I'd be interested, what role specifically does DNA testing play in this whole game of genetic evaluation?
Historically, DNA testing was used to authenticate parentage. And of course, that had a couple of different functions. First and foremost, to make sure that the ancestry was correct. But secondarily, that set the stage for really good EPDs. Next, DNA testing was really valuable to help us manage genetic abnormalities. But now the really exciting part is with our high-density testing platforms, we can make genomic-based predictions for all the performance traits that really impact productivity. And so that's what's really exciting now.
Yeah, that's very exciting. Tom, what would you add?
Well, as a commercial producer, I care a lot about longevity, docility, a lot of the traits that we really don't measure until fairly late in life. Carcass performance would be the same. Now I've got the opportunity to understand very early in that calf's life what the opportunity is for that calf to fit into my mating system, and then on our own cattle potentially to determine which marketing channel we're going to send cattle towards.
Well, the use of DNA technology is important for all segments of the beef industry. Cattlemen to Cattlemen reporter Brian Baxter has more.
The pace of change in the beef cattle industry has made a leap forward with the growing use of DNA technology to learn the precise genetic fingerprint that determines how each animal will perform.
Back not that long ago, in 1989, there was one marker for marbling. And from there, it's grown exponentially in recent times. We started 2009 in Pfizer Animal Genetics with a 56-marker panel that does a great job for three traits. And 1 year later, we started 2010 with a 50,000-marker panel that covers 13 traits and has the flexibility for expansion to almost an unlimited number of characteristics. And so it has come of age, and it's exciting times.
I think we're certainly moving in a direction where competitiveness and narrower margins are potentially going to force us to identify ways to make more informed decisions. And certainly there's a number of different ways to do that, but I think genomics is going to be a very important way to make those more informed decisions.
Whether it's a seed stock operation, a commercial producer, or a feed yard, Kent Andersen says the range of DNA products from Pfizer Animal Genetics puts genetic information in the hands of producers so they can make more accurate decisions.
There's two ways we make improvement in our beef cattle populations. It's through either selection, finding those outlier animals that do lots of things well, and then propagating them more rapidly. And then also mating, making sure that we are able to match sires to groups of females that accentuate their strengths and help their weaknesses. And so the nifty thing about this technology is that it allows us to increase the accuracy and to improve the scope of selection across more traits. And by doing so, we're able to identify early in life those animals that that are genetically superior across the traits of economic importance, such that we can more rapidly propagate them, and such that we can more wisely mate them to the opposite mate that accentuates things as much as possible.
The traits that are important will be unique to the segment of production that we're working in. So the traits that are important to a cow-calf producer may include things like weaning weight, the propensity to rebreed quickly, birth weights, for example, feed efficiency, some of those traditional traits that are important in profitability of the cow-calf person. Whereas for other segments of the industry, things like tenderness and marbling and yield become much more important.
Andersen believes the addition of DNA sampling to a seed stock and commercial cattle operation can build on existing tools, such as EPDs, and help producers make better breeding and selection decisions early in each animal's life.
It increases the accuracy and the scope of selection. So we can save all the time and all the money associated with selection decisions that using traditional technology may or may not have taken us in the right direction. So bottom line for me, why should producers use the technology? Is that it can help us make more dependable decisions for genetic improvement, and that avoids lost time and opportunity in the form of mistakes that might be made using only traditional ways of evaluating animals. And the vision of Pfizer Animal Genetics is that a marriage between that time-tested and dependable use of pedigree and performance data with the new opportunities created by genomics is the most optimum. The idea is that by using all available information, the traditional pedigree and performance, along with the new genomic information, we're then able to integrate that into one single prediction of genetic merit across each of the traits that has maximum reliability so that producers can make decisions do so with more confidence.
Delivering superior genetics is the goal of the Pfizer Animal Genetics team. It's a goal that benefits all segments of the beef industry.
Tom, no doubt this is technology that's been around for a few years, but I'll be honest with you, a number of folks that I've talked with have taken a real wait-and-see attitude. Why do you think it's important to take action now?
You know, I would have been counted amongst the skeptics even 5-10 years ago. But as I've watched this technology evolve and seen the rapid speed ability to actually take this full mapped genome and begin to mine out the information, we've got an opportunity of a lifetime. And the great thing about this technology, this is not a size of operation limiting technology. This works whether you're a large operation and actually for small producers. If you're a small seed stock producer, this gives you a chance to leapfrog in the information realm. And the reality is in this market today, no information, no market.
We'll follow up on that in a little bit. Did you know that you can find Pfizer Animal Health on Facebook and Twitter? Like us on Facebook at facebook.com/PAHUS/livestock. Follow us on Twitter at Pfizer_beef.